I have mentioned many times in the past that if you do an online search for the interpretations of quantum mechanics, you'll find at least 30 different interpretations. 30 at least. Quantum mechanics by itself is a mathematical recipe for predicting the outcome of experiments. And the mathematics has led to technologies such as lasers, semiconductors, transistors, quantum computing soon in the future, and actually innumerable technologies that we take for granted, including toasters and the incandescent lamp. Until recently, the most accepted or popular theory of quantum mechanics was the Copenhagen interpretation, which implies consciousness as causing the collapse of the wave function until a measurement is made by a conscious observer behind the scenes, behind all the instruments of observation. Until that measurement is made, a particle exists in superposition with all other particles. But right now, the multiverse theories of quantum mechanics are becoming very popular. In fact, I recently interviewed former Caltech professor Sean Carroll, who had written a book called Something Deeply Hidden, where he proposes that that is the right interpretation of quantum mechanics. Multiverse, multiworlds, and there are many kinds of multiverse theories. But the whole revolution in that direction was started by a physicist called Hugh Everett, who proposed the many worlds interpretation. So let's delve with that a little bit because it has fascinating implications. Remember that even the many worlds interpretation is conceived in consciousness. You can't get behind consciousness. The many worlds interpretation, which was originally proposed by Hugh Everett III in 1967, posits that all possible outcomes of quantum events actually occur, but in separate parallel worlds. The interpretation eliminates the need for wave function collapse, a concept central to the Copenhagen interpretation of quantum mechanics. Here are some key concepts in this theory. The universal wave function describes the state of every particle in the universe and encompasses all possible states and outcomes. According to the many worlds interpretation, every possible outcome of a quantum event is realized in a separate parallel universe. There is the concept of branching universes. When a quantum event occurs, the universe splits into multiple branches, each representing a different outcome. Reminds me of morphogenesis and differentiation. A single stem cell differentiates into different outcomes: eyes, nose, teeth, tongue, lips, fingernails, genitalia, brain, etc., each with its own little universe. Okay, but let's continue with this. For example, in the famous Schrodinger's thought experiment, one universe would have a live cat while another would have a dead cat. These branches are non-communicating and evolve independently. All these parallel universes exist simultaneously. There's no single timeline that progresses from past to future. Instead, every possible timeline exists concurrently. This means that different versions of events and outcomes are all real but occur in separate parallel worlds. There are implications for time according to this theory. So there's no flow of time. In multiverse interpretations, time does not flow in the traditional sense. Instead, all time states exist simultaneously. Each universe or timeline is static in its own right, with no movement from one state to another. This challenges, of course, our everyday experience of time as a linear progression. Perhaps you've heard of the concept of decoherence, which is also invoked. Decoherence is a process that explains why quantum superpositions appear to collapse into a single outcome in our observed reality. It also helps define the preferred basis of these splits, ensuring that different branches of the universe do not interfere with each other. The process is crucial for maintaining the independence of parallel universes. Reality is not only stranger than you think it is, it's stranger you can think. While multi-worlds interpretation is a prominent interpretation, other multiverse theories also suggest the existence of multiple timelines. So there's the inflationary multiverse. This theory suggests that different regions of space-time undergo rapid expansion or inflation and form separate bubble universes, you know, like one bubble differentiating into or forming separate little bubbles. Each bubble can have different physical constants and laws, leading to a vast array of possible timelines and realities. Of course, everyone's heard of the string theory, which posits the existence of multiple dimensions beyond the familiar three spatial dimensions and one time dimension: length, breadth, height, and time. These extra dimensions could host different universes with their own timelines and physical laws. And then, of course, everyone's now heard of black hole cosmology, which suggests that each black hole could contain a new universe inside it, leading to a nested structure of universes. Each of these universes could have its own timeline separate from the parallel universes. Now, could it be possible that these different universes, as part of the multiverse, could they be entangled non-locally? So I went on my search, and this is what I got. It said, in the context of multiverse theories, particularly the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, the idea of different universes being entangled non-locally is complex and speculative. The many worlds interpretation suggests that all possible outcomes of quantum events occur, but in separate parallel universes. Each universe represents a different outcome, and these universes are typically considered non-interacting and independent from one another. And then it suggests the following: quantum entanglement is a phenomenon where particles become interconnected, such that the state of one particle instantly influences the state of another, regardless of the distance between them. This non-locality challenges classical notions of locality and realism. Experiments have shown that particles can exhibit correlations that cannot be explained by any local hidden variables, suggesting a non-local nature of reality. However, this non-locality is typically confined to particles within the same universe. While entanglement implies a deep connection between particles, there is no current evidence suggesting that this entanglement extends across different universes in the multiverse. I ask this question: can future quantum technologies link these different universes? It said speculatively that it's possible. The search engines said that. So Why do I even bring this up? Well, I had mentioned this aphorism from the Yoga Vashishta. Infinite universes come and go in the vast expanse of consciousness, like motes of dust dancing in a beam of light, shining through a hole on the roof of my cave. That's what the original quote is. This is an ancient sage saying this. So here's my take. If consciousness is infinite, then it can have infinite expressions. These theories are conceived in consciousness. And of course, as I've said before, experiments are designed in consciousness, observations are made in consciousness. So in the infinite consciousness, do infinite universes exist? And I would say that they do. Infinity is infinity. It cannot be compromised. And in the infinite, all infinite scenarios are possible. So, who are you? Who am I? How can the human mind actually comprehend this, mathematically compute it, and then actually look for evidence and slowly but surely come up with the evidence? First a concept, a theory, an idea, and then experiments, and then observations, and there you have it. You create the reality. Reality is conceived, constructed, governed, and comes into existence in consciousness alone. And I would place my bet that as we explore all these theories and continue to explore them, and there are many theories, by the way, there's Aronoff's time symmetric theory, which says past, present, and future and infinite timelines are all entangled in the matrix of existence. And there is the transactional theory of quantum mechanics. All of them seem to be true depending on the context and the math and the bias, literally the bias of the scientist. The scientist who's coming up with the theories. But they're perspectives. And maybe all perspectives are true in a different context. Going back to the teachings of the Buddha, all perspectives could be true. In fact, that's one of the Eightfold Paths to Enlightenment. Right perspective is all perspectives or no perspective. And no perspective only happens in timeless now, where all these infinite timelines are branching out, creating infinite dimensions of experience. So everything ultimately comes down to experience. Replace the word objective universe with the word subjective experience. Before you can call anything an object of experience, it is a subjective experience. That too, in a limited mind, using a limited brain. And even with that limited mind and brain, we have all this unraveling of the mystery of our existence. And so I would posit this is the evolution of cosmic consciousness through the human mind. The human mind indeed has the ability to tap into the cosmic mind. Okay, friends, this is it for today. If you have any questions, you want to engage with me, connect with me on digitaldeepak.ai. And also a reminder that Digital Dharma is now available. Thank you, and may the infinite be with you.